What does practice make?
Mother.
Perfect.
Yes,
and Summer is hard at it. If she's going to command the stage for over 2 hours, it's paramount that she gets her line spot on.
But then I didn't want to waken half the Abbey, so I went back up. Go up here. That's the hardest rule of all for me. Sister Margaret has
all this on top of the imminent release to the press of Summer's Secret.
When Summer left Hollyoak, she let the rest of the cast in on her secret that she was going to go on to become Maria. But it's only now that the story's been revealed to the press, and it has created quite the stir.
Summer, along with her famous theatrical aunt, Bonnie Langford, is doing a photo shoot for the TV Times. And Bonnie is all too aware of the pressure mounting on Summer's shoulders.
She doesn't show that she suffers nerves very badly. She keeps it all in. But she does get nervous, I know she does. She gets all angsty. She's not as confident as you think. And I'm sure that she will find different obstacles along the way. I have no doubt that she will overcome them and she will rise to this challenge. I think there's a certain standard within the family that one is expected to reach. If you're going to do something, do it well. The thing about our job is that people think that you're having such fun. And a lot of the time, yes, you are. But, you know, to do something, particularly like Summer's going to do 8 times a week, it has to have that freshness and has to have that life and joy. And sometimes you just ain't in the mood. But that's when it's your job to have a certain standard that you never go below.
I think the press have been very, very amused, and I think not only that, I think that they've sort of said rather good on you, because it's something nobody would have really done. I think that if you did think that, they would think, what's he done now? He's got a girl who's getting a cast from Hollyoaks. But nobody joined the dots up, actually. I think what they didn't see was the plot in which she was going to end up through Hollyoaks, ending up in The Sound of Music. That's the amusing thing. I mean, it's like all these things, when we won't be able to do it again.
Doing the press isn't a chore for me, because I want to get as many people wanting to come and see, come to the theatre. That's the whole point, is to open people's eyes, I guess.
With her opening night only days away, Summer's invited onto Sarah Cox's radio show. But she's only running late.
Traffic on the way into the car, traffic in the car. Oh, God.
So, Summer's coming in. She's the Hollyoaks hottie I was talking about. Well, that's not the only string to her bow. In fact, I suppose that's the smaller string to her bow. The main one is she's a huge West End musical star. Well, she'll sing a little something for us. That'd be nice.
I hate being late as well. It's like one of my pet hates. Yeah. It makes me like...
Oh, it's a bit of a slapdash, this one, isn't it? Right then. So. God. So, Summer is here. Poor thing, but she's all out of breath.
And I just want to kind of know, in real life, you're called Summer and your character's called Summer.
Yeah.
Because of this crazy tie-in. Because this morning in the office, I was like, what's she called? It was like Summer. And I'm like, I know that. I mean, what's the actress? It's Summer. Oh, right, of course.
It's got to be.
It wouldn't work, would it? So how's it been on Hollyoaks? Have you enjoyed it?
Oh, it's great, yeah.
What's harder work, sort of, so intense in a West End show, or Hollyoaks, where they do a lot of filming as well?
It's very different. There are so many different things. I mean, in Hollyoaks, it's so fast moving. You have to learn your lines, and you know, every night, and you're given new bits every day. Whereas on a show, obviously, it's more
kind of doing the same thing every night.
Yeah. But it's still quite, you know, it's still very hard work. So, you know, they both have their pros and cons.
When was because I'm madly jealous of people who can sing. When was the moment where you thought, God, that sounds all right? Or somebody
Well, to be honest,
was it when you were tiny?
I hate the sound of my own voice, hate it. Can't listen to it. But I think it was probably my grandmother and my mother, sort of, they must have heard it when I was about 6, I think.
So your auntie is Bonnie Langford.
She is, yeah.
Is that on your mum's side?
On my mum's side, yeah.
You do have I can kind of see a little connection.
Yeah,
it's
especially
the kind
when
of family where you all look like each other,
really. Yeah, we're a bit like peas in a pod. I, on stage, look really like Bonnie, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you nervous?
I'm nervous about the press, see what they have to say about it. But,
no, I'm sure you do brilliant. It was really nice
to meet you.
Summer, I don't think, was really ever a young child. Summer always, as a little girl, had this amazing voice that was, you know, hello, it's Summer. She was never this kind of cutesy child like some of the others were, and like some probably me. And she was adorable and was always terribly sensible. And where the rest might be a little bit kind of... Summer was always calm and working everything out, even at the tiny age of maybe 3 or 4. Summer knew where she was going. I think she was always very focused.
I have worked really hard to get where I am, yeah. Really hard. I mean, I was working as a child. I did panto every year from when I was 3 until I was 15. That was really hard work, but great, because... And I am so pleased that I did, because all of those things have... I've taken something away from.
So rehearsals are underway and I'm just dropping by for a little bit of do, re, fa, ma, lati, whatever it is, just to see how things are going, really.
Do a deer, a female deer, ray a drop of golden sun.
Dancing must... Hi. Oh, come
here. Hey.
Hi.
Hey, how's it going?
Yeah, fine, thank you.
Nice
what
to
you
see
doing?
You. Yeah, just come in to see how it's going and stuff.
Yeah?
What are you
it's
up
going
to?
Going well. Well, I'm just... doing a bit of work on my own, just doing do re mi at the moment. So
okay,
I've got lots of work
sure. What's been the most challenging thing so far about rehearsals? Anything that's taken you by surprise?
Probably the amount that Maria's on stage. I think it's a two hour 40 show, and she's on about 2 hours 35 minutes of that.
Is it starting to get more nervy now? It's feel more
it's
real.
It's definitely getting more nervy now, yeah. I mean, the technical stuff, like the changes, I've got so many quick changes. I mean, every other scene is in a different costume.
I imagine that wearing a nun's habit feels sort of naughty.
A bit crazy, yeah. Mm. It is a little bit naughty.
Will you be keeping it?
Yeah. Pretty much.
Can
Might
you
put it on
get
bam bam.
Me one?
Yeah, if you like. I'll see what I can do.
I do.
With the sound of music. With songs they have sung for 1,000 years.
Stretch out for a bit so that we don't get...
There's no doubt that success in the theatre is a hard-won goal, but it's here in the rehearsal room where you start paying. Paying in sweat.
I'm just going to, I've got some stuff. I'm going to just slip in something a little more comfortable. Hang on, just one.
Okay. You look... pretty sweet.
Yeah. So,
Well, there's a bit in Do Re Mi that I always have a bit of trouble with.
I'll help you out. It's fine.
But, yeah, so it starts off with Do. And we go Do.
Do. Got it.
Me, me.
Me. Got it.
So, so.
So, so. Got it.
Okay, fine. I might not be the fastest thigh slapper this side of the Alps, but you cannot deny that I've got a certain look. Anyway, Summer's got more serious and pressing engagements. The onstage rehearsals are well underway.
This show, a lot of it, well, majority of it rests on me. And thinking that 2,100, however many people there are in the theatre, are resting on on you having to have a good night, you would drive yourself crazy. So the best thing to do is just enjoy it. Well, at the moment, we're sat on the Palladium stage itself, which is amazing. You know, so many talented people have appeared on this stage, you know, have been stood right here. And, you know, I'm going to be stood right here with the lights on me. And if you do think about it too much, like I just did then, it makes me, you know, it balls me over, really. It really does.
The weight of expectation is mounting on our leading lady. Will she be able to pull off the performance of a lifetime? Will she?
Am I nervous? I will be nervous when the overture starts. That's when I'll get nervous. At the moment, you know, I'm just learning it, and I'm trying to get the role as good as I can, and then when the overture starts, that's when the pre-party jitters, I call it, that butterfly feeling, like when you fall in love for the first time and you're like, ooh, your stomach feels like you're going to be sick. And then I have a glass of water and I go, right, come on, do it, let's do it. And I'm still really nervous, but you have to kind of just breathe past it.